Welcome all to the fourth edition of SWIS Campus News. I'm your host, Blake Elliott. In the last month of 2015, we have come to a time for celebration and more exciting events. First up, let's celebrate with Grade 5. See what they've achieved in the PE Learning Unit.
On November 13th, Friday, Grade 5 had been working very hard on a PE learning celebration in gym. The learning celebration is for celebrating the end of their second unit of inquiry, how we organize ourselves. The students choose their own songs, they create their own urban dances, and use individual skills to pass or jump over obstacles. Each class had almost 3 minutes for their urban dances composition and 3 minutes for their parkour presentation. There are also many beautiful artworks around. The artworks were done by grade 5 students who linked with our lines of inquiry based on urban dance, parkour, guided by Ms. Claire Paisley and Mr. Will Jiang.
The Swiss basketball team. We may not usually hear about them, but yes, they're an exciting team sweating on the basketball court. Last Monday, they were on their last tournament before basis.
On Monday, November the 23rd, the Swiss basketball team went to GOS to play a tournament. The last off-campus one before the coming BASIS basis tournament. The girls' team played first. They did a great job on defending, blocking and attacking the GOS team, and tried very hard to get the rebounds. They won the GOS team by 1 point, 4-3, which was a huge improvement comparing to the previous two seasons. Then the boys' basketball team. The boys were fast runners, which increased the tension and pace of the game. Even though they lost the game by 6 points, 12-18, the boys participated actively, tried their best, and enjoyed the event.
Wow, what an exciting basketball game. We are so proud of our boy and girl teams. Service project is a very important part of the MYP program. 4 different service project groups presented what they've done in the theater on Tuesday.
On November the 24th, the second MYP assembly took place at the Swiss Theater. During the assembly, representatives of the MYP service ASAs, including the Cambodia Orphanage, Chenzhou School Building Project, Global Issues Network, and the Helping Animals Club, introduced their activities, completed actions, and latest status to our students and staff. Now the ASA student leaders will introduce their projects to you.
Was environmental degradation. Our gang focused on paper waste, and so we first learned about a lot about paper waste and environmental degradation, and then we created an action plan. So from June 852, I learned about environmental degradation and how to create an action plan.
The Chenzhou School Building Project ASA, led by Jerry and Kelly from Grade 9, was one of the community service projects completed last year. They went to Chenzhou to donate stationeries and books, met the teachers and students there, and visited 2 of the students' families. From this trip, they gained a deeper understanding toward the situation and therefore decided to continue the project after its deadline.
So what we did is we established a after-school activity, and we have more members to join and help us together.
So this year we have already established one fundraising activity, which is the swimming gala raffle tickets activity. So that basically we sell tickets to parents and students in Swiss, and we gather about 5,000 RMB from that activity.
Hello, I'm Andy Yao from Grade 9 Green, and here speaking for the Cambodia Orphanage Service Group. Our service group is started by Mr. Drummond. Mr. Drummond has been to the orphanage with an organization for many times, and he decided to carry on the project and lead it into SWIS. Our service group's goal is to raise a fund of 50,000 RMB so we can help them with supplies such as food, water, and also to create a better living environment. Fundraising, we have activities arranged such as the free dress day on November 27th. Staff and students are allowed to put on their casual clothes to school, but you have to pay 20 RMB for participating.
Before we go today, something nice to hear from our music department. This year, they made a big success again in the festive music concert. And we will interview Miss Jameson, the head of music department, to know about how they prepare this fantastic music show.
On Tuesday, November 24th, the music department of SWIS held a festival concert at the SWIS Theater. The performers include the concert band, Chinese ensemble, string orchestra, the dance team, and the choirs from PYP and MYP. Many people came to the concert, students, teachers, parents, and some students from other schools. The entire mood for the concert was festive, as the name of the concert indicated. Our secondary principal, Mr. Legault, commented the concert as such a success and thoroughly entertaining and a wonderful reprieve from a busy work week. He said that each performance demonstrates skills, passions, as a result of hours of practice.
As the chief director and organizer, how would you comment the performance?
I think the performance was great, with so much variety, and everyone had prepared quite well. Yeah, went quite smoothly backstage as well.
How long have you prepared for the performance?
The students, we started rehearsing maybe about 10 weeks ago. We started with a kickstart to get the whole program up and running, and then we started busy work every week.
So as students have a very busy schedule at school, how do you get time for this?
It is really, really hard, because Swiss students love doing so many different things, whether it's sports and music and dance, and classes, maths classes or English classes outside school. So we try to juggle all that, and we have to actually choose music that is a lot simpler to be able to do this. So we don't try and choose really hard pieces of music that make it really difficult. It has to be simple, easy, quick to learn.
So what do you think students benefit most from this activity?
From Mr. Marwini, probably his snacks. I can see one hiding in your pocket. A sense of achievement, maybe. Working together. Doing something that is not playing with the iPad, or working with each other, I think is probably the most fun thing.
So what can we expect for the next show? Any details could be shared now?
Well, we've got quite a few shows coming up in various places, but the music department ones, we have two big ones coming up. The first one is the third annual Shenzhenbe Festival, which is happening in April next year, and that's for students 10 years old and above. And the tagline for this one is "A global community, we all belong." So that is in April, and we're going to be calling for auditions for singers coming up very soon. And then the final one will be actually our summer concert, which is I think in May. Yeah, May or early June next year.
Oh, thank you, Ms. Jameson.
At the end of our news program, let's enjoy some fantastic performances from the festive music concert.